What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today I'm going to show you how to use Proxy in Enscape for Sketchup. Let's get started. Number 1. How to import a proxy. To import a proxy, click on this icon to open Enscape Objects. Then click on Proxy and you will see a window pop up. Here you can choose a component that you want to use as a proxy. For example, I will import this tree here. Make sure that the file type is a Sketchup file, otherwise it will not work. Now I can left click to place the proxy. When imported, you will see an empty box in Sketchup. But in Enscape, you will see that it's rendered correctly. There you go. Now you can click again to place more of that same proxy component. Number 2. Import a collection of proxies. In my Sketchup model, I usually import a collection of proxies on the side like this. This often includes proxies for landscape elements like trees, flowers, rocks, etc. This way, I can easily find what I want later and I can start copying and pasting this proxy and place it wherever I want. Number 3. Use Skatter. If you have the Skatter plugin, you can use it as a way to quickly populate your site with models of trees like so. I won't go into detail on how to use Skatter because I want to focus more on Enscape in this video. There you go, looking pretty good so far. You can even do it with flowers and grass as well. Number 4. Create proxy from component. Another way to create a proxy is to create it from an existing component in the model. For example, if there is a component that's slowing down your model or is taking a lot of space, you can turn it into a proxy. First, make sure that it's a component. Then right-click and select Save as External Model for Enscape. Make sure to save this in the same location as the other proxy models to make it more organized. When you do this, the original model will be saved and a proxy will replace it. There you go. Pretty cool, huh? Number 5. Updating a proxy. Remember, you can also use proxies for interior elements as well, such as this set of furniture here. However, sometimes you need to make a change to that model, like changing the material or moving a part of the model, such as this piece of furniture here, which is blocking the doorway. First, you will need to open the original model. Then make the changes. Next, save the model. Now go back to the scene. There it is, it's been updated. As you can see, Proxy is a really powerful and convenient way to add more details to your render without slowing down your model. And there we go, that's how to use Proxy in Enscape for Sketchup. And that's all for today, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, comment below if you have any questions. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.